My name is Joel Patrick, Director of Solutions Engineering at Beyond Trust. This short video will be going over some of the Vault features in privileged remote access. PRA Vault gives you the ability to store, inject, and check out credentials. These include Windows domain accounts, local accounts on Windows domain systems, and individual local accounts on Windows systems where there is a pre-installed jump client or agent. PRA Vault can also store, inject, and allow use for non-managed accounts with usernames and passwords, as well as SSH keys. Finally, PRA has a personal vault to store credentials. PRA Vault has the capability to discover Windows domain accounts, local accounts on Windows domain managed systems, and import RDP connections for systems from Active Directory. PRA Vault can also rotate credentials based on a predetermined intervals or after use. Now, let's take a look at privileged remote access and vaulting. Before we get started, in my demo environment, I have something called a jump point, which is our proxy client installed in my lab. Here in my lab, smelab.local, I have two different jump points running in an HA configuration. These jump points allow me A, to have access to Active Directory to be able to manage credentials, and also allows me to create RDP sessions for devices that are on remote networks. Let's switch over to the console. Here we have the access console. This could be done both in a thick console like I am here today, and also a browser-based console. The first session we'll be doing is a RDP session where the credential that I'll be injecting into the session comes from the vault. So here my credential jpatrick.vault is being pulled out of the vault within PRA, and it will then allow me to initiate an RDP session with this workstation or server. So a click of a button, and I am connected to this remote device. We have full clipboard synchronization and auditing and logging of everything that I do. Here we'll do the same thing with another machine as well. This is one of my domain controllers. This time I'm using a different credential to log into my domain controller. Here I'm also again injecting a credential into an RDP session, and here I am continuing some work that I was doing in ADUC, or Active Directory Users and Computers. Go ahead and close out of those two sessions. Now, some other examples that we have here is our pre-installed agent. The pre-installed agent we call a jump client, but here on one of my application servers, I have an agent running on that device, and instead of connecting to an RDP session, that agent allows me to scrape the screen of that device, and I could also inject again that same credential out of the vault into this remote device. Again, the advantage here is I have auditing and logging of everything that I'm doing. Just like the RDP, we also have file transfer, we have terminal level access, all within an audited and log session. And again, when I end the session, it actually checks back in the credential that we used for this session. And then if I had my product set up that way, it could also automatically rotate that credential that I just used. Another type of example of a session that you can do is one of our optional features called web jump. So here, when I'm working remote and maybe I'm at the office and I need to connect into my home lab, or I'm at my home lab and need to connect, we have a feature called web jump. So this is my ESXi host in my lab. I have a credential for my ESXi host, and it will seamlessly inject that credential into this web application. So again, the idea here of this is the jump point that we mentioned earlier that's used for proxying can also be used for a web-based application. So here I'm logged into, just using the static IP address, for my ESXi host.